살아계신 아버지 하나님, 오늘도 저희들에게 예배의 단을 쌓을 수 있는 은혜를 허락해 주시고 날마다 말씀의 자리를 놓치지 않도록 성령으로 인도하시니 진심으로 감사드립니다. 아무리 바벨론 같은 우겨쌈을 당한다 할지라도 변함없는 아버지의 사랑을 깨달아서 날마다 감사한 마음으로 하나님을 찾고 구하는 평강의 성도들 되게 하여 주시옵소서. 나라 민족이 어렵고 힘들 때마다 더욱더 믿음으로 기도하는 민족이 되게 하여 주시옵시고 자신들의 이익을 위해서 당파 싸움보다도 진심으로 나를 걱정하고 근심하면서 미래를 준비하는 지도자들이 될 수 있도록 인도하여 주셔서 평강제일교회를 사랑해 주셔서 구속사의 말씀으로 열방의 복음을 전하는 사명을 허락해 주셨사오니 주인의 마음으로 늘 생각하고 행동해서 날마다 영적인 생명의 능력으로 일하는 교회가 될 수 있도록 역사하여 주셔서 구속사 세미나가 열리는 현장마다 기쁘고 좋은 소식을 전하는 기회가 되게 해주시고 하나님의 은혜가 넘치게 하여 주셔서 참된 말씀의 진리를 깨닫는 은혜가 있도록 역사하여 주셔서 이를 위해서 수고하고 관심하는 모든 손길마다 세상의 근심 걱정이 모두 사라지게 하시고 오히려 이전보다 더 큰 축복이 모든 가정과 직장과 생업체에 넘치게 하여 주옵소서. 특별히 질병으로 고통당하는 성도들을 붙잡아 주옵소서. 모든 치유의 가정마다 아버지께서 간섭하여 주셔서 믿음으로 기도할 때 기적을 베풀어 주시옵시고 낙심하고 불평하고 근심하기보다는 더욱더 믿음으로 나아가는 순종의 자녀들이 될 수 있도록 인도하여 주옵소서. 이 시간 말씀을 사모하며 달려 평강의 성도들을 붙잡아 주셔서 날마다 아버지의 기쁘신 뜻대로 일할 때마다 자손만대 예수 그리스도의 축복이 떠나지 않도록 축복하여 주옵소서. 오늘도 생명의 말씀을 전하시는 담임 목사님 성령의 은혜로 붙잡으시고 선포하는 말씀이 땅에 떨어지지 않고 열매로 결실을 맺는 귀하고 복된 시간이 될 수 있도록 도와주옵소서. 특별히 찬양으로 영광 돌리는 에바다 선마대와 바울 오케스트라의 헌신을 기억하여 주옵시고 도저히 우리에게 막막하고 답답해서 사람의 힘으로 풀리지 않는 모든 문제들도 찬양대의 힘찬 찬양을 통해서 막혔던 담들이 무너지는 역사가 있게 도와주옵소서. 오늘도 먼저 택하여 주신 은혜를 기억해서 입으로만 하나님을 찾고 구하는 자가 아니라 진심으로 하나님을 기쁘시게 하는 택한 평강의 성들이 되게 하여 주시옵소서. 믿사옵고 존귀하신 예수님의 이름으로 간절히 기도 올리옵나이다.
We pray all of this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
오늘 함께 은혜와 생명 양식은 에스겔서 40장 14절부터 17절 말씀입니다. 다 찾은 줄 알고 봉독하겠습니다. 에스겔서 40장 14절 말씀. 그가 또 현관을 점령하니 방이 60 규빗 하여 현관 사면에 뜰이 있으며 바깥문에서부터 앞문 현관 앞까지 50 척이며 움직이 방에는 각각 닫힌 창이 있고 문 안 좌우편에 있는 벽 사이에도 창이 있고 그 현관도 그러하고 그 창은 안 좌우편으로 열려있으며 방문 벽 위에는 종려나무를 새겼더라. 그가 나를 데리고 바깥들에 들어가니 늘 삼면에 박석 깔린 땅이 있고 그 박석 깔린 땅 위에 여러 방이 있는데 모두 30이며 이는 하나님의 말씀입니다. 아멘. 에바다 성가대 찬양 읽겠습니다.
We will now have the choral anthem from Ephatha Choir.
Thank you very much.
Our orchestra and our Ephatha choir has given such a hopeful choral anthem that has glorified our God. At this time, it is the 30th study of Ezekiel's redemptive history. It is our 30th study of Ezekiel's redemptive history. We are studying Sabib, Sabib, and this is the fourth session of Sabib, Sabib.
Now,
in our last session, we talked about the temple that was at the top of the mountain. And the expression Sabib, Sabib that appears here. So if we were to draw a picture, so think of this as the outer wall of the temple. So this is the outer wall. And this is 3,000 cubits. So it's 3,000 cubits all around. And inside of this is Ezekiel's temple. Now, the walls of Ezekiel's temple is 500 cubits. And the mountaintop where this is at, if you look at Ezekiel chapter 43, verse 12, it says that the top of this mountain all around, it shall be most holy. And we see the expression Sabib, Sabib here. Now, this outer wall, we have these four sides. And when we look at Ezekiel chapter 42, verse 15 and 20, so this is the top of the mountain. And here we also have the outer wall of the temple. And in Ezekiel chapter 40, verse 5, so we see here again the walls that are all around, the outer wall and also the wall of the temple. And this is what we reviewed last session. Now today, for main point number one, we shall take a look at the outer courtyard, the Sabib Sabib of the outer courtyard. Now the Sabib Sabib of the courtyard, we see in Ezekiel chapter 40, verse 14. So this is from our opening scripture. Let's read it together. Let's read this together. Verse 14. And he made the side pillars 60 cubits high. The gate extended around about the side pillar of the courtyard. So we see that there is a courtyard.
Sabibu, Sabibu라는 히브리어죠. 그래서 우리가 지난번에 배웠듯이
and this expression that of going round about is Sabib, Sabib. Now, the word Sabib, when it is used twice, it is speaking of something that is going all the way around. It is encircling something. So if we're going to draw a picture, if this is Ezekiel's temple,
so
we see this courtyard. So this is the courtyard that's outside, and on the east, we have this gate.
요 아래쪽이 남쪽이죠?
So the bottom here is actually the south, right?
위쪽이 북쪽이고.
The upper part is the north.
남쪽에도 현관이 있고 또 북쪽에도 이렇게 현관이 있죠.
So we see these.
그래서 이렇게 현관 좌우로.
We see these.
남쪽, 동쪽, 또 북쪽.
These gates.
현관 좌우로.
That are being. Extended around to the left and to the right, and from there there are these pillars, and all of this is called the courtyard.
말씀하고 있어요. 그래서 여기서 이제 우리가 한 가지 주의할 것은,
so one thing that we must be careful about.
있는데,
so we have
이 현관이 우리말 성경에는 20척이라고 나와 있어요.
Now, in the Korean translation, these pillars are described as being 20 cubits. But our founding pastor, he is teaching that this is actually a mistranslation.
So,
the expression 20 in Hebrew is shishim. Shishim. That is 20. Shishim. However,
20이 아니라
this expression is not
뜻이죠.
actually 20,
그러니까
but it means 60.
20척이 아니라 60척이라는 거예요.
So these side pillars are not 20 cubits according to the Korean translation, but they are actually 60.
아일이라는 단어예요. 아일.
Now the 아일. pillars in Hebrew 아일. is 아일.
아일은
아일.
기둥이잖아요.
And this is speaking about pillars.
이 문 벽을 가리켜요.
And it's also speaking about the wall of the doors.
기둥이
So these pillars,
벽의 높이가
the height of this is 60 cubits high. So these are the borders of the gateway.
그림으로 그려보면
So if we're going to draw a picture, we could probably draw it like this.
여기 이 현관을
Now,
현관을
this pillar,
여기 이렇게 표시를 했어요.
I've expressed it as such.
여기 들어가는 입구가 있고,
so there's an entrance here.
모양으로 해서 이렇게 안으로 들어가는데,
and you go inside as such.
이 높이가
the height of this
60 cubits이라는
is 60 cubits. So this height is 60 cubits.
문 벽의 높이가 60 cubits.
So the wall that borders this gate is 60 cubits. And what is this in our modern measurements? It is 31.92 meters. So this is 30 meters high. So our Moriah sanctuary is about 13 meters high. So the height of this is actually twice that of Moriah. So Ezekiel chapter 40, verse 14, let's look at this again. And he made the side pillars 60 cubits high. Now these pillars in Hebrew is Ayil. Ayil means pillars.
그리고 광이 20척이요 돼 있는데
And the height
20척이요가 아니라
was
60척이요
60 cubits.
히브리 원문에 맞는
So the original Hebrew says 60 cubits. So in the Korean translation, just cross out 20 and write down 60. This is the proper translation of the original Hebrew text.
높이가 적게 적어놨으니까 잘못된 거죠.
So this is actually three times higher than the Korean translation.
이렇게 해서 이 현관을 이 현관이 동쪽에도 있고 남쪽에도 있고
Now these pillars are in the east, the north and also the south.
이렇게 바깥뜰이 있었다.
And
성경은 말씀하고 있죠.
It says that the gate extends round about to the side pillar of the courtyard. So we can understand this, right?
자, 그다음에 두 번째로
Now secondly,
박석 깔린 땅에 사비부 사비가 있어요. 박석 깔린 땅에 사비부 사비부. 자, 이건 뭐냐면은요. 이제 지금 이게 현관이잖아요.
Now,
현관.
If we take a look at the pillars here,
현관. 그리고 문 벽이
And
벽이 쫙 올라가는데 그게 60척이니까
the walls,
30, 약
the pillars of
31.9m
are extending high about 60 cubits.
좌우에 뜰이 있는데
Now to the left and right of this,
박석이라는 돌이 깔려 있다는 거예요.
We have this courtyard.
박석이라는 돌이 이 사방으로 깔려 있는 거죠. 그래서 이 박석 깔린 돌을 표현할
And there are these stones that are all about.
사비노라는 단어가 사용이 되고 있어요.
And in describing how spread out these stones are, it uses the expression sabib sabib. We see this in verse 17. Let's take a look at this together.
시작.
Begin.
그가
Then
나를
he
데리고
brought me into the outer courtyard,
들어가니,
and behold, there were chambers and a pavement made for the court all around.
30
chambers faced the pavement.
여러 방이 있는데 모두 32며 그랬죠. 그래서 여기 에스겔 40장 17절 말씀
so
보니까
Ezekiel chapter 40 verse 17. It says that in the outer court, there's this pavement.
삼면에라는 단어가 사비부 사비부예요.
And the expression for the courts all around, the pavement that goes all around, is also sabib sabib.
18절 말씀 보면 현관을 중심으로
And when we take a look at verse 18.
깔려 있는 거죠.
It says that the pavement was by the side of the gates.
리츠파라는 단어죠, 히브리어로.
So in Hebrew, the expression for 리츠파. pavement is ritzfa, ritzfa.
리츠파.
ritzfa.
이 리츠파는요.
Now, ritzfa,
이게 얇은 돌을 이야기해요.
It's describing about very thin stones.
이 돌이 아주 깨끗하고
However,
맨들맨들한 돌이에요.
They're very clean cut stones. They're very clean stones.
돌을 깔아놓는 거죠.
And so this pavement is laid with these types of stones.
방이 30개가 있다 그랬잖아요.
But it said also that there were 30 chambers.
나중에 이제 공부하겠지만은
We're going to study this later on.
요 사면에
But
이렇게 40급이
pavement
부엌이 있어요.
We have
하나님이 사면에다가 다 부엌을 이렇게
We have these kitchen areas.
백성들을 위한 부엌이죠.
And this is for the people.
요 부엌과 현관 사이에다가
Now between these kitchens and the pillars
이렇게 방을 만든 거예요.
There are these chambers.
방이 계산해 보면 다섯 개씩
And if you calculate it we see that these chambers are placed five in a row. So we have these chambers that are distributed by fives. So we have five here and five here. We also continue to have five chambers here. And also five chambers here.
그러면 총 방이 몇 개가 있을까요?
So all together, how many chambers
하나,
do we have?
둘, 셋, 넷, 다섯,
so
개니까,
we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 times 5, these are 30 chambers all together. So we saw the expression 30 chambers previously, right? In Ezekiel chapter 40, verse 17, we see the 30 chambers. So with the stones that are very neat and clean, they are laid down for the pavement.
돌이 없는 데가 없으니까.
So the stones are everywhere.
삼면에 사비부 사비부다.
So because they're all around, the expression for this is sabib sabib. And secondly,
왜 서쪽에는
why
서쪽에는 박석 깔린 땅이 없었죠?
On the west, there is no such description of payment of pavement.
자, 이쪽이 서쪽이잖아요.
Now, if you look here, the we have the west side here.
박석 깔린 땅이 있어요, 없어요?
But is there a pavement
없어요.
or not? There's no pavement, right? Why is that?
여기는 문이 없기 때문에.
It's because there is no door.
문이 없기 때문에 사람이 출입할 수 없으니까.
There is no door. Nobody can enter through that side, so there is no need for a pavement. So pavement.
성전에 들어올 때
It, when you come into the temple, for example,
let's
say you have shoes
발에, 더러운 것이라든지 and you have, 무슨 잡것이라든지 things that are unclean,
such as dust or residue. So in with that kind of filth, you're not able to enter the temple. So as you go across the pavement, you're supposed to dust this off, and it means you're supposed to enter the temple cleanly. So Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 2 or 5 verse 1 it says that you have to guard your steps when you go into the house of God. So God is trying to preserve holiness. And that is the and third, the purpose of the pavement. The purpose of the pavement is for holiness. So that is why the pavement has been made. So if we took it Leviticus chapter 11, verse 44, and also verse 45, it says, I am holy, so you must be holy. God said this. Now we have this wall of the temple, right? So we have this wall. And what was the width of this wall? We learned this in the last session. So each side was 6 cubits. So it's about 3.1 cubits. Right? So with this, if we include the wall plus the pillar, what is the total distance? It is 50 cubits. 50 cubits. So this outer wall, or this courtyard, has a width of 50 cubits. So we've seen how the pavement also expresses sabib, sabib. And thirdly, the kitchen areas are also have a sabib, sabib.
자, 이 부엌은 바깥뜰에 동서남북 네 귀퉁이에 있다 그랬죠.
It says that in the four corners we have these kitchen areas. In the picture, these red squares, that is the kitchen area.
Now,
for the priests, it is actually inside the temple, but these kitchens here are for the people. So their size is 40 cubits by 30 cubits. So its length is 40 cubits and its width is 30 cubits. So 40 by 30, 40 by 30, 40 by 30, and 40 by 30.
부엌이 꾸며져 있어요. 그래가지고 담이 있고 부엌을 이렇게 막아가지고 담으로 만들어 놓은 거죠.
These walls encompassing the kitchens here.
공기가 나갈 수 있도록 and 터졌을까요? 막혔을까요?
The roof, in order for the steam to go out, there is an opening in the roof.
음식 환기가 되고
and that is how you can maintain the cleanliness.
원로 목사님께서는
our founding pastor
그 환기통을 만들어가지고
one thing that he always made was an exhaust. So that you can take out the bad air. And our Zion Sanctuary, we made a shower facilities, right? But we made it too quickly. We actually did not include an exhaust system.
So
many people are taking showers, and there's so much steam, you can't even see the mirror, you can't see how much soap you're using. So a lot of our people went through a difficult time. So next year, in order for people to be able to see properly, we're going to make the exhaust system. So this kitchen, in the four corners, also have this kitchen. And it is also expressed as Sabib, Sabib. We see this in Ezekiel chapter 46. Ezekiel chapter 46, verse 21 through 24. Let's find this together. Ezekiel chapter 46, verse 21 through 24.
Ezekiel 46,
verse 21 through 24.
자, 시작.
Let's read this responsively. Then he brought me out into the outer court and led me across to the four corners of the court. And behold, in every corner of the court there was a small court. So this is talking about the courtyard. In the four corners of the court there were enclosed courts, 40 cubits long and 30 wide. These four in the corners were the same size. So we see here, the length is 40 cubits, and the width is 30. And verse 23, and there was a row of masonry round about in them, around the four of them. So around the four of them it says that there's a row of masonry. So round about in them, this expression is sabib, sabib. Now this word in Hebrew is sabib, behem, sabib. Sabib, behem, sabib. So we see the expression sabib coming twice. So sabib, behem, sabib.
이렇게 해서 사비브가 이렇게 두 번 나온 거죠.
So we see Sabib coming twice. So
그다음에 그 사면 부엌에 쌓는 기구가 설비되어 있는데 부엌이니까 이제
So this is a boiling place.
설비되어 있는 거죠.
This is a place where you boil. So let's read verse 24. Then he said to me, These are the boiling places where the ministers of the house shall boil the sacrifices of the people. So this is the places where you boil the sacrifices of the people. So in these three instances, we've seen the sabib, sabib. So we saw it in the courtyard and also the pavement all about the courtyard. And in the boiling places. So in conclusion, we'll take a look at the redemptive administration of all of these things. First, Ezekiel's temple is most holy.
거룩으로 보호되는 성전이다. 자, 여기
So Ezekiel's temple is a temple that preserves the most holiness.
성전 산 꼭대기 주변도 거룩하죠.
So this is on the mountaintop and all around the mountaintop is most holy. And this outer wall is protecting the holiness. And also the temple itself has a wall that protects the holiness. Now We have the 50 cubits in width of the pavement that is preserving the holiness. And in the four corners, we have these boiling places. On the top, there is a place of exhaust, and these are also enclosed, and it preserves holiness. So, we can understand that Ezekiel's temple protects the most holy. So we must become holy in order to enter Ezekiel's temple. This is what it's teaching us. We must be most holy. So can I be holy just because I want to? In the world, it doesn't work that way. You have to be absolutely holy. Your words must be absolutely holy. Your life needs to be holy. Your personality needs to be holy. All of your actions have to be holy. And that is how you enter Ezekiel's temple. So in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 15 and verse 16, it says that you must be holy in all of your behavior. So be holy in all of your behavior.
우리가 말씀을 깨닫는 것도 중요하죠.
So it is important for us to realize the word. But
말씀을 깨달을 뿐만 아니라
we cannot just understand the word. But through that word, we must become holy, and we must bear the fruit of holiness. So Romans chapter 6, verse 19, and also verse 22, it says that we have to bear the fruit of sanctification. So you might think, oh, this word is very deep. And yes, you must understand this deep word. But however much you understand it inside your head, now that the depth of God's word, it must go deep inside your characteristic, inside your personality. If you yourself do not become holy, then you cannot enter Ezekiel's temple. That's the time that we're living in. So it is important to understand the word, but it's now time for us to bear fruit. So Matthew chapter 21, verse 43. It's like when the landlord comes, what will happen? The ones that bear fruit, the ones that bear fruit, they are the ones that will receive the kingdom. So, through the word of Ezekiel's temple, all of your behaviors will be made holy. All of your behavior will turn into holiness, and that you can bear that fruit, I bless you in the name of the Lord. So this is a temple that preserves absolute holiness, the most holiness. And secondly, what we can understand is if we're going to enter Ezekiel's temple, if we're going to enter Ezekiel's temple, we must clean our feet. We must clean our feet. We must wash our feet. So in Proverbs chapter 5, or in Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 1, when you enter the house of God, you have to guard your steps. See, what is the pavement? When you come in with your steps, it means that your feet need to be clean. See, if there's something attached to your feet, if your feet are dirty, you cannot enter the temple. So our feet, it means that we need to repent. What do we need to repent for? For spilling blood. We have to repent for spilling blood.
So,
to spill blood, it means that you're killing other people. In Romans chapter 3, verse 15, or Proverbs chapter 1, verse 16, also, Isaiah chapter 59, verse 7. If we see here, it says that your feet are swift to shed blood. So shedding blood means what? It means it's not saving other people, but it's killing other people. So your feet are swift to kill. The word of God is the word that saves. So if we receive the word of our Father, then we must do the work of saving others. However, we all gather together, and it's like, hey, how are we going to kill that person?
How are we going to...
So we gather together to try and kill another person. So with that person's feet, they can never enter Ezekiel's temple. So you're killing other people, you're shedding blood. We don't even know ourselves, but our feet are swift to shed blood. And this is what we must repent for. We cannot enter Ezekiel's temple in this way. So when we kill others, we must not have the feet that are swift to kill others, but I hope we can have the feet that are swift to save others. And secondly, for what kind of feet must we repent for? Second, so first we saw that we need to repent for feet that are swift to shed blood. And secondly, we must repent for the feet that have walked the evil way. So when we look at Psalm chapter 119, verse 101,
악한 길로 갔던
It says, I have restrained my feet from every evil way in order to keep your word. So if we have received the word of God, we must do good deeds. We must cover for others. We must save others. We must take care of them. And that's the work that we have to do.
강도 만나가지고 거반 죽어가는 사람이 있었잖아요. 근데 제사장도 그냥 지나가.
So there was a person who was attacked by thieves, but the priest they passed away, the Levite passed away, but the good Samaritan, he saw this person, he took him up, took him to the inn, fed him, clothed him, anointed him with oil. So for us, our feet that have walked this evil way, we must truly repent for this. And that is how we were able to enter Ezekiel's temple.
So,
Ezekiel's temple, you see, we see this measurement of 3,000 cubits, 500 cubits. You see, all of these things are important to understand. However, our personalities, our characteristics, we must actually change. But our mouths, we speak curses and evil, nothing's actually changed. That means it means nothing. So, we have to be able to bear fruit, to enter God's kingdom, to enter Ezekiel's temple. So Psalm chapter 119, verse 101. Let's read this together. Psalm chapter 119, verse 101.
Psalm
chapter 119, verse 101. Let's read this together.
시작.
Ready, begin. I have restrained my feet from every evil way that I may keep your word. See, it says it here. In order to keep God's word, we have to restrain our feet from every evil way. So if there are feet that walks this evil way, then we must repent. So how do you repent? If you look at Psalm chapter 119, verse 59, it says that my feet turned to God's testimonies. So if you're close to the word, if you hear God's word, then the word will say to you, hey, where do you think you're going? You're not supposed to go that way. So the word will cause you to repent, and the word will cause your feet to turn, to walk the path that is delightful to God. So the word is that important. See? When you hear the word, then it won't go away. It needs to be inside of you, and that word is what will keep you. The word will keep you. Psalm chapter 119, verse 59. Let's read this together. Psalm chapter 119, verse 59. Ready, begin. I considered my ways and turned my feet to your testimonies. It says it right here. It says, to your testimonies I turned my feet. Now, in our language, it says, I considered my ways and turned my feet to your lessons.
그러니까 말씀만이 나를 돌이키는 거야.
So the word is what turns your feet.
우리 발은
And thirdly,
우리 발은
our feet
복된 소식 복음을 복된 소식을 전하는 발이 돼야 된다.
We must have the feet that declares the blessed news, the gospel, the good news. And this is how we enter Ezekiel's temple. So these feet are called beautiful feet. These are beautiful feet. Isaiah chapter 52, verse 7. Please write this down. Isaiah chapter 52, verse 7.
자, 우리 다 같이 한번 읽어보겠습니다.
Let's read this together. Isaiah chapter 52, verse 7. Isaiah 52, 7.
자, 시작.
Ready, begin. How lovely on the mountains are the feet of him who brings good news, who announces peace and brings good news of happiness, who announces salvation and says to Zion, your God reigns.
어찌 그리 아름다운고 어찌 그리 아름다운가?
See, it says how lovely are the feet of him.
히브리어로 나아라는 단어예요.
Now, in Hebrew, the 나아, expression for 나아, lovely 나아. is 나아, 나아.
그런데 이것은요.
Now, this expression,
최고의 아름다움을 가리켜.
It's speaking of the most beautiful,
아름다움.
The most lovely.
최고로 아름답도다.
It is the most beautiful.
나아예요, 나아.
And that is what 나아 represents.
야, 당신은 나구나.
See, you are 나아. You are the most beautiful.
그래서
you are the most lovely. So this word
신약성경에는
in the New Testament,
로마서
if we look at Romans, chapter 10, verse 5, we see this expression.
복음을 전하며 산을 넘는 자들의
I'm sorry, Romans chapter 10, verse 15.
아름답도다.
It says, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news of good things. Now, the word na'a, when translated into Greek, it is translated horaios.
Horaios.
Now, horaios,
this word, 꽃이 만발한 이런 뜻이에요. 꽃이 만발한, 만발한.
It means
활짝 폈다 이 말이야. 꽃이 활짝
폈어. It's used to express a flower that has bloomed in the best way.
So,
the feet that proclaim good news, not only is it the most beautiful, but their life is so beautiful like a flower that has come into bloom. Now this person, will they be able to go enter Ezekiel's temple or not? They will enter. So in Psalm chapter 93 verse 5, this expression na'a, it means the most beautiful, but in Psalm 93 verse 5,
같은 대조되는 단어로 사용되고 있어요.
It is used to express the holiness. So it means holiness. So the most beautiful is holy.
그러니까 우리가 전도만 하면
so when we evangelize,
하나님이 나를 꽃이 만발하게 만들어 주시고
God will make me bloom like the flower. He will make me the most beautiful. He will make me holy. And automatically you will be able to enter Ezekiel's temple. So what did our founding pastor say?
He says,
so those that have sinned must evangelize.
See?
So he, our founding pastor had expressed this for those who sinned. Why? Because when you evangelize, your feet become like the, your feet become holy feet, they become feet that bloom with beauty, so you're just able to enter Ezekiel's temple.
So,
how precious are the feet that proclaim the gospel? So, if we had walked the path of, if we have walked the evil way, if we walked the path of killing others, let us repent. And let us go out to call others and evangelize, and this I bless you in the name of the Lord. Now, some people,
아,
what is evangelism? See, you speak the word and you bring them to church. But there are some people who they evangelize, but then they take people out of church.
See,
see that is not a blooming flower, but that is a wilted flower. See, there are people like that inside church too, isn't there? It's like they try and entrap other people. And they themselves leave from church, but then they take two or three other people with them. See, how terrible is this before God?
See,
are the man of God, our founding pastor, he loved the church so much. He loved the church so much that it was clean enough that you can eat off the floor. So it's joyful to evangelize and bring people into church. But if you take people out of church, is that something that's joyful? We have to rethink this. So when we evangelize, we need to have the feet of bringing people into church. And your feet throughout your lives will have the flowers that bloom. And that you can enter the New Jerusalem, that you can enter without fail Ezekiel's temple. This I bless you in the name of the Lord. Let us pray.
하나님 아버지
Our Father God,
오늘 또
today,
거룩하고 복된 주일을 맞이하여 우리의 발걸음을 세상에 버려두지 아니하시고
not
주의 abandoned 몸된
us
교회로 강권적으로
our walkways to the world but you have guided us here we thank you so much through holiness through sabib sabib This holy temple, Ezekiel's temple, we desire to be able to enter. Father God, if we had the feet that were swift to kill others, please, we repent now. Please forgive us. If we had done evil deeds, we ask for your forgiveness. Now, let us proclaim the word of redemptive history and be evangelizers that can bring people into church. May our footsteps be the footsteps that bloom like the flowers, that let them be the footsteps that are the most lovely and the most beautiful. Let us surely be able to enter Ezekiel's temple and guide us as such. Father God, are there any among us whose bodies are ill at this time when we pray with our right hands laid upon where we are hurting? Lay the right hand that is stained with the blood of the cross upon us. Please cleanse us of all illnesses. At this time I command in the name of Jesus Christ that all illnesses will be cast away, that our bodies will be cleansed with healing. At this time I command in the name of Jesus Christ that all problems within the church will be cast away. They will be cast away. We believe that all things will be fulfilled according to how we have prayed. We pray all of this in the precious name of Jesus Christ with all thanksgiving. Amen.
우리 다 같이 은혜 찬송 415장 찬송을
Let us sing hymn 415.
영원부터 영원까지 살아계신 사랑의 하나님 아버지
Our loving God who lives from eternity to eternity we thank you so much
하나님의 구원 목사가 끊어질 위기 속에서도 언약을 이룰 자를 세우셔서 오늘 우리에게까지 이 귀한 말씀을 허락하여 주신 아버지,
our Father God who has permitted you this precious word with all of our hearts and all of our faith before you, let us be those that can keep your will. The Satan and the devil is trying to make us fall away, but through the word and through prayer, may we be able to cast out the devil, let us overcome the world, and let us be able to understand your precious love. At this time, we thank you for the word that you have given to us, and we want to give to you our offerings.
You don't,
our God who looks deep into our hearts, we pray that you will be able to receive these offerings with joy. We thank you so much, and we pray all of this in the holy name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you for the grace of
giving praise. The 16th district has given a praise. Kim Young-chun Jang-nam gave a thanksgiving offering. I believe that God has accepted these with praise. I believe that there will be great blessings through these offerings. We will now have
announcements.
The Biblical History of Redemption Seminars will take place as the following: August 23rd to 24th in Canada, August 26th through 31st in Colombia and Ecuador, August 31st in Myanmar.
9월 10일은
September 3rd in Busan and in September 10th in Paris, France. The Samuel Vacation Bible School will take place August 24th at the Jubez Sanctuary, second floor. We ask for your participation. The second book of the sermon compilation, The Absolute Thanksgiving with an Emptied Heart. Let us all rise, sing hymn number 6, and we'll conclude with the benediction. Now, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the abundant love of our Father God, the fellowship, inspiration, comforting fellowship of the Holy Spirit, now be upon all of the saints who, by being most holy, will declare the gospel at the feet of God to declare the gospel. Let this blessing be upon their families, their businesses, upon this church forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. 모든 예배를 마쳤습니다. 한 주간도 승리하시기 바랍니다.